Hi everyone and welcome back. So in the previous video we have seen how React Redux actually works. Now in this video we will talk about what is Redux toolkit. I mean, we were using Redux with React, everything was fine, and then we suddenly started using Redux toolkit. So there should be some advantage of using Redux toolkit on top of Redux. It's not like Redux is totally different from Redux toolkit. It just says, it is just like we are still using Redux, Redux Flow. It's just like we have changed the way of using Redux to simplify it. Okay. So, I mean, we were using Redux. Redux was a predictable state container. We were writing reducers, which is a pure functions, which means same state and actions passed will always result in the same output. It is also easily maintainable and scalable due to the strict organization on how we. So when it comes to looking at the current Redux implementation, even if we see this particular code, we have written a lot of actions, a lot of reducers, right? These are the actions, and here for each we have written the reducers, and here we need to maintain the immutability at each and every stage, right? So Redux toolkit is getting rid of that. It is providing the Emerge.js implementation, and so Redux toolkit is trying to solve high level couple of issues, you can say. I will not say that those are issues, but when it comes like we are writing a big project, then we wanted to write a more cleaner code. So currently we are writing too much code to configure the store to optimize to a particular level and to use the best practices. We are writing too much boilerplate code, like even in the reducers you can see too many lines of code we are writing to make it immutable. We are writing too much actions and reducers makes it more complex. Do you see, like, for compost I have created a different actions and then particularly reducers and then combining all the reducers, creating the store. So it's like if we talk about the big projects, I will be creating actions for each and every, maybe a container component and then reducers for them. So Redux toolkit is trying to reduce that by just using simple utilities. It's not like we are changing the flow, we are changing the structure. It's like that we will start using the dependency, another dependency which is Redux toolkit here. So here you can see Redux toolkit, Redux.js toolkit. This we will start using, and we will still be using the React Redux library. So let's see what is going to be changed when we start using Redux toolkit. Okay, the way we are creating the store will change. Okay. So first of all, we'll just install the Redux.js toolkit either through npm or yarn, and now it is providing all these APIs. So configure store, a new way of creating a store. We can create a reducer. I mean, now we will be just creating a store, and store will have actions and reducers inside it. We will be more focusing on creating a slice. So I will directly go into the code level implementation. So you will understand more from there. Okay, quick start and example. So here, I mean, create store is converted into configure store. You just pass all the reducer object, okay, here, and then you just pass the store same way in the provider. And then here we are talking about the important aspect. We started creating the slicing. So we will be using create slice method. Inside create slice, you can say the name of the slice, the what is the initial state, and these are the reducers. And based on the actions, we are not managing the immutability and all these things because Emerge.js and the existing implementation is taking care of that. Here we are just updating the state like this, but it is still immutable internally. We are just updating state.value, state.value, state.value. So here we don't need to maintain, okay, this is the current state and this is the new state. By using spread operator, object.assign, array.map, filter, or all the immutable implementations. Okay, let's first talk about this. So what are the changes? You can say we instead of create store, we are using configure store, and then we are passing that store to the provider that we were doing earlier. Now we are using create slice, right? And it contains the initial state and all the reducer functions. And then inside our component, we will be using use selector and use dispatch. These are the hooks. If you are writing a functional component, you can use these hooks to actually access the Redux state and to dispatch the action to the Redux state. Okay, so we will use things one by one. If I wanted to change the existing code we have here, add this dependency, this is a step one. Now I will change this code and I will also share the, let's create a fork of this. So it will not change the existing code. Now, instead of creating reducer, instead of creating store, we'll just change the implementation how we are creating a store. So go to app.js. Here we are using create store that will be converted into configure store. Okay, so here we can call configure store. And here you can initialize, this is an empty object. Or if you already have created, then you can add all the reducers here inside this list. So this way you will create a store and you are passing the store to the provider. The next thing is you will create a simple actions. Okay. And here the important part is we don't want it to write reducers and action folder. I will just create a folder slice. Slice will take care of all these things, and I will just simply create index.js or to-do slice.js or something like that. Here I need to get the create slice from Redux.js toolkit. Okay, and I can import. So all these APIs are there, you can see. Create actions, create action thunk. I'm talking about create slice. And with the slice implementation, export const, we can just put the slice name counter slice. And we can use the create slice method. Now, this create slice method takes a couple of arguments like name, which is counter, and what is the initial state that we were providing in the reducer also. So I'm saying is my initial state value is 0. And then all the reducers. It is like the logic we are going to write to update this initial state. So it can be increase. You will access the current state. And here we, even if it is an object, what we are doing going to do is we'll just say state dot value to something else. So increase and decrease, these are all the reducers. And then what you will do is you will create, you will get all the actions outside of this. So we already have the counter slice dot actions. Now what all actions you received from this increase and decrease, right? So I don't need to write actions separately and then the reducer separately, and then I can just export default counter slice dot reducer, and then this reducer we are already exporting, and this reducer I can pass to the create store, right? So you can call it as a counter reducer. I can pass the counter reducer here inside a reducer object. Okay, I'm going to have it as like a counter, and here I can say is that is a counter reducer, and we can import this, import counter reducer from slice. Yes, that's it. So now the way we were creating store is changed, right? Now we can, if you wanted to dispatch the actions from the component or access the state want to access the state inside any component, that we can do. So I will just create a simple dummy component here inside src. Let's say my test.js. I mean, we just wanted to see how the things had changed. So first of all, import React from React, and then here we will write a simple functional component, export function counter. So this is our simple functional component, and I will use these use selector and use dispatch utility. Like use selector is there, this we can use to access the state. Use selector, I do have access to the current state. From that, state.counter.value, this is how you can access the state. Export function. Now if I want to dispatch something, then what I can do is I can use const dispatch equal to use dispatch. This is another hook we have. They are creating warning. Leave it. So inside this, what we can do is we can just let's say simply I'm just displaying the count value. So counter or simply count value I can display, and here I can add on click action. Simply on click action will look simple like this, on click, and inside on click I can simply say when you click onto this div, I'm going to dispatch. What is the method? Increment we have. I'm going to call increment, and you can have another tag or span or whatever. You can do on click again to just call another method, which is decrement, and we are done. So what is the conclusion here? Now everything is reduced to a simple slice. We are creating a slice, we are defining all the reducers, right? All the functions, we are exporting them as actions, and then we are exporting those to the outside so that I can consume them wherever I need. And here these I'm exporting this reducer. Now you can see this counter slice. Similarly, you can actually create other slice, define the initial state, define all the reducers, export all these actions. So we actually kind of combined the reducers and actions into a simple single file. You don't need to worry about immutability of the Redux state. I mean, you can simply say I'm just saying state.value. Even if the state is an object, nested object, I would be doing state dot particular property equal to this, state dot particular property equal to this. I don't need to worry about immutability because that is being taken care. So those are the advantages. I mean, it is Redux Toolkit is a great option for both beginner developers and who wanted to reduce the amount of boilerplate we are writing in the Redux. It allows us to write cleaner and more readable code while keeping the Redux flow pattern. I mean, we are not deviating from the Redux flow pattern. We are still using the same pattern. It's just like we started using the different methods, configure, store, different way of dealing with the async APIs, and started writing slices, which combines the reducers and actions. Okay, let's see more examples in the future videos to understand more about Redux Toolkit.